What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com. Previously we talked about the conditional statements in PL SQL and their types. In today's tutorial, we will see the first conditional statement in PL SQL, which is if then, or you can simply say if condition. If then is the most basic kind of conditional statements in PL SQL that enables you to specify only a single group of action to be taken. You can also say that this specific group of action is taken only when a condition is evaluated to be true. Correct me if I am wrong. I think if conditional statement is used in almost every programming language. If you disagree, then do comment below and tell me which programming language do not support if statements. Okay, now let's quickly take a look at if then structure in PL SQL. In the starting, we have the keyword if, which marks the beginning of if then block, followed by a valid condition or a valid expression which will get evaluated, followed by another keyword then. Similarly, the reserve phrase end if marks the ending of if then block. In between, we have a sequence of executable statements which will get executed only if the condition evaluated to be true. Otherwise, the whole if then block will be skipped. Hope this is clear to you guys. Now let's do some practical examples which will help you in understanding this concept more clearly. So let's go for it. Okay, this is a very simple PL SQL anonymous block. In the declaration section, I have declared a variable v underscore num with data type number and initialize it with integer 9. Let's come to our execution section. Here, as you can see, we have two DBMS underscore output statements. One is inside the if then block and another is outside it. The first DBMS underscore output statement will execute only if the condition of our if then block is evaluated as true, otherwise it will be skipped. But the second DBMS underscore output statement, which is outside the if then block, will execute every time you execute this PL SQL block. This means that if the condition is true, then both the strings inside the if and outside the if will be printed. Otherwise, only the string outside the if will be printed. So let's execute and see the result. Right now, condition is v underscore num less than 10, which is true as current value inside the variable v underscore num is 9, which is smaller than the integer 10. Let's execute. Here is the result, where both the string is displayed back to you. Now let's change the condition and make it false, then execute and see the result. But first, let's close this script output. Okay, now let's change this if condition. Okay, now the condition is v underscore num greater than 10, which is obviously false. Now let's execute. And as you can see, this time in the result, only the string from second DBMS underscore output statement is printed. Let's do another example. But first, let's close this script output and clear the screen. Okay, now let's do the example. This one is slightly different than the previous example. Here we use logical AND operator in the condition. If this condition is evaluated to be true, then both strings from both DBMS underscore output statements will be printed. Otherwise, only the string from second DBMS underscore output statement will be displayed back to you. This example is for showing how you can check multiple conditions in single go using logical operator. You can even use logical OR instead of logical AND operator. Let's execute this block and see the result. And here is our result. You can visit my website and read more about the same topic. Link is in the show notes. That's it for today. Hope this tutorial helped you in understanding the concept of if-then conditional statement. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. Also, do share these videos on your social network with your friends and help them in learning. Most importantly, don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on my Snapchat, Twitter, and Instagram. Again, links are in the show notes below. Thanks for watching. I will see you soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.